Our area's most beautiful properties deserve the finest realtors. Meeks Realty Group. We focus on buying and selling residential and commercial properties throughout the tri-state area. Contact Meeks Realty Group online at meeks.us or call 304-440-1101.
The views and opinions expressed on this program do not necessarily reflect the views and opinions of 580 WCHS, its employees, or WVRC Media. From the studios of WVRC Media, the country, the United States of America, the state, West Virginia, the city, Charleston. This is the Dave Allen Show on 580 Live. And your host.
What we've got here is failure to communicate.
He's kind of a big deal.
I have come here to chew bubblegum and kick ass, and I'm all out of bubblegum.
Dave Allen.
And a good Tuesday morning to you from the Parmar Store Studio. Welcome to the show. Ryan Nicholson is our producer today. Bigly Piggly Wiggly, hotline 304-345-5858. Fruit Pharmacy text 304-935-5008. The Dave Allen Show and 580 Live brought to you by Thornhill Auto Group, including Thornhill GM Superstore. If you're looking for a powerful, luxurious, and innovative truck, come check out the new 2024 Chevy Silverado 1500 Crew Cab LTZ and High Country. Find new roads to Thornhill GM Superstore. Click or come by ThornhillGMSuperstore.com or on the Thornhill Motor Mile, US 119 in Chapmanville. We do the show from the Parmar Store Studio. If there's not a Parmar Store near you now, there will be soon. Parmar and Game Changer presenting the annual Parmar Shootout on the campus of West Virginia State University, February the 5th through the 8th. Four big days, eight exciting boys and girls basketball games each day. First games tip off at 9:30 in the morning. For a complete list of games, visit Parmar Stores on Facebook or X. And if there's not a Parmar Store near you now, there will be soon. We are truly loaded up this morning as we approach the filing period deadline at midnight on Saturday. Coming up on the show, we've got Terry Burns. He's standing by next. He is running for House of Delegates. We've talked to him once before. He's back with us again. Plus, Stephanie Abraham, who's running for Kanawha Circuit Judge, will be stopping by. With all the snow we had last week and the cold temperatures, I'm about over it, as you may be, but one person who is not. And that's Joe Stevens from the West Virginia Ski Association. He's going to join us, and it is official now. Current State Auditor J.B. McCuskey is now a candidate for Attorney General. He signed up yesterday at the Secretary of State's office, so we'll talk to J.B. about that. Plus, your calls and texts are welcome, too. Bigly Piggly Wiggly, hotline 304-345-5858. Fruit Pharmacy text 304-935-5008. Let's welcome to the show Terry Burns, who is a candidate for House of Delegates. Good morning, sir. How are you?
Morning, Dave. How are you? I'm fine.
Welcome back to the show.
Thank you for having me.
And you're a Republican candidate, is
yes,
that right?
I am.
All right. And tell us about the district again.
It's District 53. It's basically mostly the eastern part of Kanawha County.
Uh-huh.
You've got Hughes Creek, Witcher's Creek, Kelly's Creek, Camel's Creek. You've got
if it's a creek, you got it. Is that what you're saying?
Pretty much. If it's a creek, it's in mine.
Okay. So why is it that you're running? Why do you want to do this?
I think if we can do better than what we have in the past on the eastern part of Kanawha County, I think it's been ignored. I really think we can make things better for the people in that area, and we've got nothing up there right now. The eastern part of Kanawha County is dying, and I think the legislature has pretty much ignored it. We've got all these politicians, they talk about shovel ready sites.
Mm-hmm.
There are some sites in the eastern part of Kanawha County that could be made shovel ready. But yet, nothing's been done. And I think we need to do that. I really think we should get something up there. I know LG made the announcement they're coming.
Mm-hmm.
They mentioned Kanawha County. Why do we not try to lure LG to the eastern part of Kanawha County? It's a good location. You've got the turnpike's there. You got Route 60 that goes right into the interstates along with the turnpike. I see no reason why we couldn't put something up there. You know, a few years ago, we had a company come in that was going to put an ammunition site there, which everybody figured out pretty quick that was a no-go.
Mm-hmm.
But that site is still there. So why do we not get that site shovel-ready, and maybe we put an ammunition site up there, And by the end, we could put maybe the sell ammunition to the federal government. That would be income for the state. Taxpayer could get some relief from the tax money coming in.
Mm-hmm.
I think that would be a good thing to do if we can get everybody on board to get the site ready and find somebody to come in and do it.
I can tell you're very proud of the area that you want to represent, that Upper Kanawha Valley. What is it about the Upper Kanawha Valley that you think maybe people might have a misconception about?
I think that the things that happened in the years past, I think that maybe got a bad reputation, but now if everything is coming together, the people come together. If something happens, the people stick together. If there's a flood, then everybody pitches in, and we put everything back. You know, the Camel's Creek got hit not two, three years ago, mm-hmm. and then we got up around Chillon, they got hit a couple, 3 years ago, and everybody sticks together, and they make it happen because the federal government doesn't come and help.
I've seen and people that I've talked to on the show, not just those, Terry, that are running for office, but others, that I definitely see that pride that people that are from the Upper Kanawha Valley. Matter of fact, I get texts to the show frequently with somebody will say something like Upper Kanawha Valley proud or something like that. It is an area that people take a lot of pride in.
Yeah, I mean, I've born and raised there. Mm-hmm. I've been on Camel's Creek my entire life, which is 63 years mm-hmm. almost. So, I know the area. I know the people. If something happens, we know where it's at. If somebody says Pond Gap, we know where Pond Gap is. You know, if it's Baker's Fork, we know where Baker's Fork is. Everybody in that area has been all through the area. You know, there's ATV trails. I mean, I think the legislature should be looking at that. Maybe we extend part of the ATV trail system into Kanawha County, into the eastern part of the Kanawha County. That would bring some maybe economic development that way. I mean, there is hundreds of miles of trails that could be developed, and we could make it work. I mean, it could work. It's just we got to get the politicians on board to do it.
Talking again with Terry Burns, who's a Republican candidate for House and District 53. The Dave Allen Show on 580 Live is brought to you in part by Huston's Pizza. This month, it's your favorite Huston's. Get a large 18-inch pepperoni pizza and an order of appetizer meatballs. Only $24.99. Dine in, delivery, or pickup. Visit hustonspizza.com. Give us the bio on Terry Burns.
Born and raised in Camel's Creek my whole life. Matter of fact, I was born in April, and we had a major flood in 1961, which is the year I was born, mm-hmm. and the flood came in June. And my mother carried me out of the house in waist-deep water. So, I mean, we get floods. That's just the nature of the area we live in. Mm-hmm. It's hills. You get a lot of rain. It runs off. You get floods. You do the best you can with it. But, you know, I've been married for like 32 or 33 years now.
You better get that right, man.
Yeah, it's been a while.
I tell people all the time, I know when I was married, I just can't do the math in my head very
exactly.
Well.
That's the thing. I've got one daughter. She lives in Lewis County. Mm-hmm. So, you know, she's kind of away from home, but I thought she might come back someday, but I don't think that's going to happen.
Yeah.
But, I've been here all my life, 63 years almost.
Then what have you done in your life?
I worked for the Division of Highways for like 20 years and retired. Mm-hmm. So I've got the experience in state government. I know what works and doesn't work. Mm-hmm. I know what needs fixed and how to fix it. And there's a lot that needs fixed in state government.
I want to ask you about, you mentioned your daughter there, and she's in Lewis County, which is, that's not exactly like being next door, but it's also not like being in California either, that you're that far away. You're obviously right. within driving distance, not that far. But how do we get younger people to want to stay in West Virginia? That's part one. And part two, Terry, how do we get people that maybe left West Virginia to go to North Carolina or Ohio or Indiana or wherever they went? How do we get those people to want to come back? What do we need to be doing differently and under the dome to make those people want to come back?
I think it starts with jobs and good paying jobs. You got to have good paying jobs to keep them here to start with. And then you got to have opportunities that they want, like an ATV trail, or maybe the sports complex that they're doing at the Civic Center or the Town Center, maybe that would help out. But you have to have activities. You know, I always thought maybe we should have a Cedar Point amusement park, mm-hmm. but put it up at Snowshoe somewhere. And once Corridor H is done, you'll have pretty good access. And that way you could have a year-round thing. You have to have activities that would draw them here. You can't do the status quo and think they're going to stay because they're not. Mm-hmm. And I think we need to be asking the kids that leave or are thinking about leaving, we need to ask them, what would it take for you to stay? Mm-hmm. What do we need to do? Because that's the next generation. We need to get the next generation here.
Have you been keeping an eye on the current session of the legislature? Have you been watching it? Anything in particular that's kind of stuck out to you, gotten your attention?
I think that the death penalty thing is kind of ringing everybody's bell. Mm-hmm. I think I could support that if the circumstances were right. I think you got to be careful, and it could end up costing us a lot of money. And then on the other side of that, I saw a thing this morning. I think it was in Oklahoma. There was a guy that was on death row, and they found out now that maybe he didn't do it.
Yeah.
And he's had three execution dates.
Yeah.
So you got to be careful when you do that, because there is no coming back from that.
Right. Now, you mentioned your background with the Department of Highways. What do you think about the road system in West Virginia? There's obviously been some improvements everywhere you go. There's orange barrels up, but as somebody who is kind of an expert in that area, what's your take on it?
I think we can do better. I don't like the way we pave roads. A lot of these roads we're putting down 1 inch of asphalt. That's not going to last. There's no use spending $14 million to pave a mile of road when it's only going to last 3 years. That's why I think you got to be careful with all the bonds that they're talking about floating. You can't, you cannot use bonds for a paving project. It's just a bad idea. It doesn't work. You're going to be paying for your bonds way past the time when the pavement is gone. Mm-hmm. So we just can't do that.
So if you are elected and you go in, you're going to find yourself, Terry, dealing with a lot of people that even though they may be of your same party, the Republicans are in the supermajority, obviously, but people that have different differences of opinion than you do, even within a party, not everybody's going to agree, and they shouldn't. That's where dialogue comes from, and that's where ideas get ironed out. How do you think you'll deal with dealing with people maybe that have a totally different perspective than you do?
I think we'll be fine. I've dealt with people all my life, and even with those 100 delegates, you're going to find groups that are together.
Yeah, subsets kind of, that happens every time.
So, but it doesn't matter to me whether you're Democrat, Republican, Independent. The people have to come first. It's people before party. Mm-hmm. And you have to do that, and every legislator, politician, that should be what they do. It should be the people first, and you have to do that. If we're going to continue down the prosperity path we're on, you have to get things ready. You have to work together, and everybody has to get on the same page. I mean, you may have to compromise here or there to get what you need done, but at least you can get it done.
What's your campaign strategy like? You've been out knocking doors and doing forums and whatever. What do you do? What are you
doing? Too cold. too cold for me. I got to wait till it warms up.
Well, it's going to be in the 50s today, and the snow's melting, so you got no excuse. Get out there and knock on some doors.
But
what do you tell people? If you go to somebody, I don't know, I said that about knocking a door. Some candidates do that and some don't. But if you meet somebody in a senior center or wherever you meet them, or at the mall or whatever, and they say, well, why should I vote for Terry Burns? What would you tell them?
Basically what we said. I've lived in the district my whole life. I know the district. I know the people. I know what we need. I know where it needs to go. I know the places where we can put things. I can represent people probably better than anybody else that's running in my district because I've been in my district. I've rode ATVs up every one of these hollows that we mentioned many times. So I think, that would be a big thing. And the other thing is you don't take money from lobbyists or special interests. We need utility rate reform. If a candidate's taking $12 million from utility companies, you're not going to get any reform. You have to go in there with a clean slate, willing to make the changes and fight for what you believe in and try to make things better for everybody. I went to the PSC hearings. I've pretty much done everything that you can do to try to stop the rate increases.
Mm-hmm.
I think we're at the point now where the legislature is going to have to step in, and you're going to have to reorganize the PSC. And you're going to have to put some kind of code in law that says this is what you do. And maybe you start charging utility companies a fee to file for a rate increase. And you base it on how much they ask for. Maybe if it's the first one, you ask for 5%. If he asks for the second one in 5 years, maybe you go to 20%. And if they ask for a third one in 5 years, maybe you just make it 40%. And it can't come from the ratepayers. It has to come out of the company profits.
Interesting concept. I think there probably would be a lot of support for that. Well, Terry, where can people learn more about your campaign?
You can go to terryburns.org. There you'll find my email address, my personal cell phone numbers there. I think if you're in office or running for office, you should be available for anybody to contact you and talk to you. you know, if you got questions, call me, email me. I'll be glad to answer any of the questions you have. And hopefully everything works out.
All right. Well, we wish you the best of luck. Terry Burns, again, Republican candidate for House in District 53. Appreciate you being here, man. Thanks a lot.
It's fun to be here.
The Dave Allen Show on 580 Live is brought to you by Brightway, the Mays agency of Taze Valley. Buying auto insurance can be complicated. That's why you need a local person to look out for you. At Brightway, the Mays agency, they can customize your policies with the coverages you need and want. Call John and Sherry Mays today, 304-814-2509, or visit BrightwayMays.com. We'll take a break. We're back after this on the Voice of Charleston, WCHS.
Are you looking for a technical job in the medical field? Generations is growing and looking to add on job-trained physical therapy techs to our rehab team. To apply, visit one of our 7 convenient locations or simply click on us at generationspt.com.
West Virginia's top high school basketball talent will come together February the 5th through the 8th on the campus of West Virginia State University as Game Changer and Parmar Stores present the Parmar Shootout. The shootout has been extended to 4 full days this year. Come see the top boys and girls teams in the state battle it out, 32 games in all. The first games tip off at 9:30 each morning. Game Changer and Parmar Stores present the Parmar Shootout on the campus of West Virginia State University, February 5th through the 8th. For a complete list of games, visit Parmar Stores on Facebook and X. If there's not a Parmar store near you now, there will be soon.
Hello, I am Judge Stephanie Abraham, and I am running for Circuit Court here in Kanawha County.
Judge Stephanie Abraham was appointed to the Circuit Court by Governor Jim Justice. Judge Stephanie Abraham owned and managed her own law firm and was an attorney for the Department of Education and General Counsel for the State Board of Education. Judge Stephanie Abraham is a fair and balanced but tough judge who will always follow the Constitution to protect liberty and achieve justice for all.
I am Judge Stephanie Abraham. I appreciate your vote for Kanawha County Circuit Court.
Paid for by the committee to elect Judge Stephanie Abraham.
Ready for a different banking experience? Become a member at Members Choice West Virginia Federal Credit Union and learn what it means to be a part of the credit union movement.
MCWV is a not-for-profit organization with a mission to provide quality financial products and services, low loan rates and terms, and accounts to fit your unique needs.
As a member, you're also an owner of the credit union with voting rights, dividends, and are a part of the support given to our community.
Become a member today at 201 Ohio Avenue in Charleston or online at memberschoicewv.com. Restrictions may apply.
Member of the NCUA.
.924 of the Dave Allen Show and 580 Live is brought to you in part by Meeks Realty Group. Discover the unrivaled expertise of Meeks, your ultimate partners in all things real estate, whether it's your dream home or that ideal commercial space Meeks has you covered. Contact Rich the Realtor, 304-932-7488. Let Rich and the team guide you on your real estate journey. Take a look at their listings at Meeks.us. Ryan Nicholson is our producer today. Biggly Piggly Wiggly Hotline 304-345-5858. Fruit Pharmacy text 304-935-5008. Text says, we need change to Upper Kanawha Valley. We got flooded and no help from our representatives on the state level. County Commission was great. Only help we got, we need change badly, says a texter. Texter says, it's funny listening to Republicans complain about the federal government being ineffective when Republicans do everything they can to make the federal government ineffective. That's a texter. Texter says, young people are leaving because of conservative social policies. Will conservatives abandon party social policies to keep the youth from leaving? Nope. Says a texter. Text of the show, our service of Fruit Pharmacy. Find the perfect over-the-counter hearing aids at Fruit with NuvoMed hearing aids. Plus, Fruit makes it easier to transfer your prescription services to them. Fruit is your hometown family pharmacy and has been for 71 years. Phone calls are a service of Biggly Piggly Wiggly. When shopping at your Biggly Piggly Wiggly, be sure to join their loyalty program. You can save big at the gas pumps and throughout the store with their electronic coupons and free gifts on Fridays just for stopping by from farm to table. Biggly Piggly Wiggly. The best-kept secret in Charleston. Coming up a little bit later on, Joe Stevens from the West Virginia Ski Association will join us. He's one of those that was happy about all of the winter weather we had last week. He's counting the dollars. Well, he's not necessarily, but the association and the tourism folks are. Talk to Joe about that. Plus, J.B. McCuskey, state auditor, now officially a candidate for attorney general, will join us a little bit later on as well. Welcome in, Stephanie Abraham. How are you, Stephanie? Good morning.
Doing great, Dave. Thanks for having me this morning.
Thank you for being here. Now, you were appointed to the 13th. Judicial Circuit Court in August to replace Judge Duke Bloom, who retired. So talk about that experience so far. How's it been?
Well, it's been great, and I was thinking back this morning. It's you had me here the morning of my investiture, so mm-hmm. It's been 4 months later. Mm-hmm. It's been a wonderful 4 months, an incredible experience for me. There's a lot of things that I've learned, a lot of things that I'm awfully proud of that we've been able to do. I've been very grateful for the opportunity to preside over our juvenile drug court. Since that time, that's a program that we have to really get our kids on the right path to success, and I'm incredibly proud to be part of that.
I want to ask you about the juvenile drug court. How does that whole thing work? It's been around for a while. What kind of successes are we seeing? And just give us an idea of how the whole thing works.
Sure. It's really a holistic approach. We have a treatment team that's made up of a variety of stakeholders with regard to representatives from the prosecutor's office, with regard from the public defender's office. We have representatives from Kanawha County School District. We have therapists that work with our kids. It's really an all-encompassing approach to help the kids in the program really get invested in their futures and their families get invested in their futures. We are working really hard to build partnerships with some of our community leaders, with some of our state leaders. For instance, we have hearings tonight, and we have Phil Cantrell coming from Mountaineer Challenge. He's the state director. Mm-hmm. To speak to our kids about that opportunity, we have a lot of the same goals. And it's just a really good opportunity for them to get some information if they've expressed interest and ask some questions from them and their parents.
And so many of these kids, and I know in your experience and others in the court system have told me when they're experienced, I mean, so many of these kids are almost sadly, born with a strike against them because mommy and daddy are not part of the picture because of drugs. Grandmas, are sometimes not part of the picture. So getting them early and hopefully getting them on the right path, getting them turned around is so, so important, Judge.
Right. And that's exactly what our goal is, because I think in my background, I've already been aware of some of the issues that our kids are facing. But really being down and seeing it firsthand and being in the trenches has been profoundly humbling and eye-opening experience for me. So we're doing everything that we can to make sure that our kids can be successful and have good opportunities in the future.
So you were appointed to that position. You've been in office now for 4 months. Now you're a candidate. Why do you want to continue?
Well, like I said, I'm just proud of the work that we've been able to do so far. I think when I was back here in September, I told you and your listeners that I would hit the ground running, and I have done that. We are moving cases, making decisions. And it's incredibly great, just really wonderful for me to serve the citizens of this county.
Again, we're talking to Judge Stephanie Abraham here on the Dave Allen Show on 580 Live. The Dave Allen Show is brought to you in part by General Hardware and Lumber of Winfield. Come check out their new contractor showroom, lumber yard, and more. They deliver service and quality right to your door. Don't buy until you get a quote from General Hardware and Lumber of Winfield. In case people missed your previous appearances on the show, Stephanie, give us the bio on Stephanie Abraham.
Oh, okay. Well, before being appointed by Governor Justice, I was a attorney general counsel for our State Board of Education. Also worked as an attorney for our Department of Education, and then had my own private practice where did some work for county entities and a lot of property work. I've represented all kinds of individuals, different businesses, different governmental entities. So I have that different, unique kind of experience bringing that to the bench.
There's been some criticisms in the past, Judge, of judges who want to legislate from the bench, be it locally, even on the higher level. I want to phrase this right. What do you feel is the role of somebody sitting on that bench, and where does the line get drawn? Because you've heard the criticism, not necessarily against you, I don't mean that, but I mean across the country, people saying we have activist judges that want to legislate from the bench. How do you answer those
sure.
things?
And I can unequivocally say that that's not me. That's not my role. Mm-hmm. We don't make laws. That's the legislature's role, and it's our job to make sure that, and what I feel strongly about is following our state laws, following our Constitution, and ensuring that all the litigants that come in front of me have due process and equal protection and their liberties protected.
Give us a website or something where people can learn more about you.
AbrahamForJudge.com.
Okay, and so again, you're back at it right now, and you've got the 4 months of experience. And I kind of touched on this earlier, but we'll just kind of reiterate, there's nothing like on-the-job experience, and you're obviously very experienced, so you don't really know till you know, until you're there, and I'm sure that you've picked up some things along the way from the last time that you were here that you could say, okay, well, this didn't work, this does work, whatever, and kind of take it from there.
Yeah, and like I said, it's been an incredibly eye-opening experience, some of the issues that we're facing here in our county and that our citizens are facing in this county. We all know, and it's no secret, that substance abuse and addiction is a main driver of crime in our county. We work really hard to ensure that people have access to treatment, But we also ensure that there's justice for victims. That's just as important. I'm firm on that. I don't want my courtroom to be a revolving door of recidivism, but it is something that we struggle with and we see daily.
And we hear so many people in the judicial front that will that have told me, others, you and others on this show, that they do see sometimes a lot of the same people in there. And I don't know how you break that. That's not the role of the judicial system, but I don't know how we break that cycle. But I think of some of these things that you and others are doing with these drug courts, and you mentioned the Mountaineer Challenge Academy, which I think, I'm a big believer in that program.
I think
it's a fantastic program that we get these, hopefully we get these kids and even adults, get them turned around, because there's a lot of successes in drug courts and things of that nature too, Judge. So it's not just that I spent time talking about the kids, but there are success stories of those that are much older in life that have been able to turn it around.
Oh, absolutely. In fact, I was very fortunate to attend Judge Salango's family treatment court graduation a few weeks ago. We also have adult treatment court in Kanawha County, and then the juveniles, like I already spoke about. Mm-hmm. So really, it is an all-hands-on-deck effort.
So give me the final 30 seconds here. Why should somebody vote to retain Judge Stephanie Abraham on the bench?
Well, thanks, Dave. I am a firm believer that everybody deserves their day in court. If they are in front of me, they will have every opportunity to present their case, and I will hear it fairly. I will follow the law, not make the law like we just talked about. And that's something that I believe in, and that's something I'm going to continue to do.
All right, and we have information out there. People can learn about you on the, because you're running a lot of commercials. That's a good start on the show, on this show and this station. But you got a website, social media. They're pretty easy to find,
yep,
right?
All out there.
All right, Judge Stephanie Abraham, I appreciate you being here. Thanks a lot. Hang out with me 1 second. It's 26 minutes away from 10. Dave Allen Show and 580 Live is brought to you in part by Pinnacle Consultants, the only accredited commercial lab in the state for asbestos and mold. Asbestos was banned in some building products, but not banned for all products in the U.S. Don't expose your family or workers to asbestos, mold, or lead paint. Get with Pinnacle Consultants. They offer real estate environmental assessments for hazardous materials and air quality. Visit PinnacleCorp.net, because what you don't know can hurt you. Wiggly Piggly Wiggly Hotline 304-345-5858. Fruit Pharmacy text 304-935-5008. Joe Stevens from the West Virginia Ski Association coming up, plus J.B. McCuskey as well. It's all right here on The Voice of Charleston, WCHS.
Brought to you by the Eric J. Tarr Family Businesses. Eric J. Tarr Family Businesses live to make life better for you and your family.
We are professional grade. Are you looking for a new truck or SUV that can handle any terrain or challenge? Then you need to visit Thornhill GM Superstore on the Thornhill Motor Mile. Right now, you can get a $6,000 purchase allowance when you trade an eligible vehicle on the new GMC Sierra 1500. Or shop Thornhill's great selection of GMC terrain. You can enjoy 1.9% APR for well-qualified buyers on the small SUV that offers GMC Pro Safety Plus. Plus, you'll get a $500 purchase allowance and no payments for 90 days. Click or come by ThornhillGMSuperstore.com or on the Thornhill Motor Mile, US 119, Chapmanville. So, 5G Financial, see Thornhill for all details.
Unsure you're ready for retirement? That's understandable. After all, you only retire once. Make the smart choice and call 4th Avenue Financial. If it deals with retirement planning, you can be confident they have the experience you need. Retire right with 4th Avenue Financial. Go to 4thAvenueFinancial.com or call 304-746-7977 to book your free introductory meeting today.
Securities offered through JW Cole Financial Incorporated, member FINRA/SIPC. Advisory services offered through JW Cole Advisors Incorporated. JW Cole Financial, JW Cole Advisors, and 4th Avenue Financial are unaffiliated entities.
Nearly every day, there's a company announcing new jobs in West Virginia. Thanks to the leadership of State Senator Eric Nelson, West Virginia. Virginia's economy is growing and our future looks bright. Senator Eric Nelson has been part of the team advancing important pro-growth policies. And because Senator Eric Nelson has helped control government spending, West Virginians are receiving the biggest tax cut in our state's history. Vote for more jobs. Vote for lower taxes. Vote for State Senator Eric Nelson. Paid for by the committee to elect Eric Nelson.
Ahoy, Charleston. Winter's chill won't freeze your dreams of hitting the water. At Trojan Landing Marine, winter means one thing, unbeatable boat sales. Dive into incredible deals on a wide selection of boats perfect for your water adventures. Whether you're seeking a fishing boat, pontoon, or cruiser, they've got the vessel for you. Visit Trojan Landing Marine today in Charleston and seize the opportunity to make this winter extraordinary. Don't miss out on these amazing boat sales. Embrace the season with a new boat from Trojan Landing Marine. Full inventory at TrojanLanding.com.
23 minutes away from 10. Bigly Piggly Wiggly Hotline 304-345-5858. Fruit Pharmacy text 304-935-5000. I want to get this in here while we can. The Reds Caravan is back in town Thursday at the Coliseum and Convention Center. Starts at 5:30. We'll go live from there at 6 o'clock. Free and a great opportunity to hang out with future Reds stars, Reds execs, and looking forward to meeting Todd Benzinger, who's going to be part of that. It's all free. You can come out and see us here at the Civic Center, at the Coliseum and Convention Center, I should say, on Thursday. Now, we'll spend a little time talking about the Reds Caravan. The guys really putting this thing on locally for us, or the boss, Dale Cooper, and Jeff Jenkins from our news department. I'm going to talk to both those guys about the Reds Caravan over the next couple days. Again, we will be going live from there. So if you're a Reds fan, you got to get out to the Coliseum and Convention Center, and that is happening on Thursday night. I mean, I got a couple texts, and then we'll go to Joe Stevens. Text says, this was about yesterday's show, to the know-nothing, know-it-all genius saying banning the anti-white propaganda platform, critical race theory. By the way, if you're based on facts, it would not be a theory, says a texter, that it violates the First Amendment. You really need to know the difference between speech and indoctrination. It protects your rights to proclaim critical race theory, but it does not establish any right to teach it in taxpayer-funded government schools, says a texter. Going back to the Chris Pratt interview yesterday. Yesterday on the show, Chris Pratt, who's a member of the House of Delegates, had said he was going to run for Secretary of State, opting instead now to run for State Senate. Says, I'm confused. Pratt is running for West Virginia State Senate to make other states' elections safer, LOL, says a texter. Let's go to Joe Stevens, our good friend from the Ski Association. Joseph, good morning. How are you?
Just fine, and great news about the caravan coming in. And you know what flag I fly in front of my house. Let's go O's. And you will appreciate this, Mr. Allen, crossing something off the bucket list. My brother and I are going to spring training in March to Ed Smith Stadium and seeing the O's play.
Now, where do they do their spring training?
When or where?
Where?
Sarasota.
Oh, they're down in Sarasota. Okay.
Yep.
All right. I know Jeff Jenkins went down, I think, last year, and he may have gone down a couple other times to take in the Red spring training. That's also on my bucket list, but I'll be honest with you, I don't really care what team I go for, to be honest with you. I just want to go to spring training. I think it would be awesome to do that.
Yeah, my brother and I were like, who are they playing? Who cares?
Yeah, exactly right. Yeah. All right, Joe, so you took me to task a couple times last week, and I referred to the snowy weather and the cold as nastiness. I think you referred to it in a text to me as gold falling from the sky. All right, so can both things be right? Can we hate snow and love it at the same time?
Well, I'm not going to disagree because you have the silence button. So
yeah, all right,
we'll let that one fly. But yeah, no, I mean there are times when it can get a bit gnarly out there, as it may be. But when you're at the ski resort, or you're going to a ski resort, or you're going to be snow tubing or snowboarding or even cross country skiing. What was occurring in the last 10 days, or as I described it for you, it was white gold falling from the skies. Yes.
So let's talk about the last couple of years in the skiing industry in West Virginia, as far as snowfalls go. I mean, if you remember last year around Christmas, we had that really cold snap, and we didn't get a whole lot of snow with it, but because it was 25 below zero, it seemed like it stuck around for a while. But other than that, over the last couple of years, Joe, it's been pretty slim pickings as far as snow in West Virginia.
Well, 2 years ago, it was somewhat on the average. Both Canaan Valley and the Pocahontas, where Snowshoe is, those two areas got over 100 inches.
Okay.
But that's still under the 150 to 180. I've seen as much as, when I was working at Snowshoe, I saw as much as 298 inches in a season, but that hasn't occurred. And last year, like you said, it was limited. But with that said, we did have the cold temperatures, and that's the key. Mm-hmm. Because the resorts in West Virginia, and I'm talking about from Winter Place and in Raleigh County to Snowshoe and Pocahontas County to in Tucker County, you've got Timberline and Canaan, and over in Ohio County, you've got Ogilvie. If it's cold temperatures, they're making snow.
Sure, yeah.
And it's not artificial snow. It's not fake snow. It is real man-made snow. It is crystallized formations hitting on the ground that people can play on.
Well, I saw a lot of pictures posted online for people that when they saw the forecast, either headed to the ski resorts or maybe they already had trips planned, they kind of got their money's worth last week. Is that a pretty good assertion?
Oh, without a doubt. I mean, and yesterday I was just talking to somebody that their grandson was skiing at Winter Place, and they were still in ankle-deep snow, and you saw some of the pictures from Timberline, and you saw a picture. I saw a picture from Snowshoe, and they were in knee-deep powder. And I mean, that's just too much fun to be had by one person. And unfortunately, I wasn't one of those persons that were going downhill and having fun. But yeah, we're in good shape. But and Dave, you know, just looking ahead now, people are, you know, they got their weather apps on their phone, and they feel that is the where they get the most accurate information, and that's another story for another time.
Yes, yes.
And the person you want to talk to about that is Tony Edwards at NWS. And just call him up and say, tell me about weather apps, and that'll be an hour long show for you. But but nonetheless, we're going to come into a mild period now, But because of what has already fallen and what they've made, I mean, they dumped out water. There were millions upon millions of gallons of water in their snowmaking pond lakes that they were making snow. And man-made snow is more resilient. Yeah, it's going to be underdeveloped snow in a couple of days at some of the resorts and what have you, better known as rain, but we call it underdeveloped snow. The conditions are going to be good. And for guys like you and I, who it's going to be ego snow because it's going to be a softer scenario, and they can have some fun in it and let gravity be their friend, as it may be.
Talking to Joe Stevens from the Ski Association, for Dave Allen Show on 580 Live, brought to you in part by Bridge Valley. Are you interested in improving your company's IT workforce? Well, did you know that Bridge Valley offers custom-tailored IT training to bridge the skills gap? At Bridge Valley, you can train for little or no cost with a 50-50 salary match. Bridge Valley can also supply skilled graduates and apprenticeships for your company. Visit bridgevalley.edu/apprenticeships for more information. What kind of dollars, Joe, are we talking about for what skiing means to the tourism industry in West Virginia?
About $250 million industry.
Wow.
And that's not only at the resorts. Let's talk about people like at Winter Place, where they're lodging in Princeton, they're lodging in up in Bluefield, they're lodging at Glade Springs. So that's money being being funded in that area. You know, you're talking about restaurants off the resorts. You're talking about gas stations off the resorts. Like a good case right there at Gent, where you got a Parmar store, and you know, you just see people lining up there when they're coming in and when they're going out. So you've got an economic impact across the board, and we're also talking about right now about 5,000 jobs.
Yeah.
That is directly related, and that's not even counting the guys plowing snow, the individual and the individuals, not the DOH guys who have done just an awesome job this year to and from the resorts and that sort of thing, but the individual plow drivers that have to take care of the parking lots that people are coming to the resorts and that sort of thing. So the trickle down effect, the proverbial trickle down effect, is strong.
Well, Joe, all my weather forecasting friends, you know, from the National Weather Service and the guys that do the TV thing, Spencer and Brian and Tony and all of them, they'll always say that the weather cannot be there's certain exceptions, but for the most part, it can't be accurately predicted more than about 48 hours in advance. So Brian Hughes, I had him on a couple of weeks ago. Spencer was on last week as well, and they say that, well, we're going to have this mild period, but then it looks like February is going to be a little bit colder. So we'll play the wait and see game, and don't always trust the apps on your phone, right?
Exactly. It's weather. Whether you like it, well, weather, whatever the weather will be.
Weather going to do what weather going to do. Joe, I appreciate it, man. And where can we get more information about anything related to skiing in West Virginia? What's your go-to places as far as websites or things of that nature?
GoSkiWV.com. That's GoSkiWV.com or SkiSoutheast.com, which is just a really good portal for the industry and that sort of thing. But at GoSki.com, you will be able to find out what programs are going on and also quick links to not only the resorts but to the resort cams. And you can feel, taste, touch what's going on at the resorts live and in person.
All right, Joe, we'll talk again soon, man. Thanks a lot.
David, you be safe out there.
All right, 14 minutes away from 10. Special Olympics embodies the true spirit of sportsmanship. It's not merely about winning medals. It's about being a part of a team, practicing, and competing together. The joy and fulfillment derived from these experiences are immeasurable as athletes find their confidence and self-worth to the shared pursuit of victory. West Virginia Enriched, in collaboration with Huntington, invites you to witness the transformative power of Special Olympics. See a video highlighting the Special Olympics at facebook.com/580WCHS. We knock out a text here, and then we'll go to break. We'll come back with J.B. McCusker. Text says, Abraham, talking about Judge Stephanie Abraham, is an unelected bureaucrat who only got her position because of political connections, vote against political cronyism. Well, Judge Abraham was appointed to that job by the governor, and now she's on the ballot. So if people don't like her appointment, they don't have to vote for it. That's pretty much the way it is. 13 minutes away from 10. Lead story, WVMetroNews.com. Do you know what swatting is? It's not the best way to get rid of flies. Swatting is when someone or some things call in a fake emergency to see what kind of response they can get from first responders. Well, that's exactly what happened in South Hills yesterday when 911 took a call around 11 yesterday morning in which the caller claimed to have his parents and his brother in the house. The caller said he was barricaded in the house on Dunleavy Road in South Hills. He claimed to have shot the others in the house and would shoot anyone who else approached the house. It was all the talk around 11:30 yesterday morning. It was later found out the whole thing was false. There was a woman in the house at the time who was quite surprised to find that the SWAT team was surrounding her home. No one was injured, but a police cruiser was wrecked on the way to respond to the call. Chris Lawrence has a full story posted about it at WVMetroNews.com. At this time, they do not know who or whom or what entity, AI, whatever, placed the phone call, but the investigation continues. Dave Allen Show on 580 Live is brought to you by Morgan & Morgan. If you're injured, hire Morgan & Morgan, America's largest injury law firm. We're going to take a break. J.B. McCusker up next. Voice of Charleston, WCHS.
Brought to you by the Eric J. Tarr Family Businesses. Eric J. Tarr Family Businesses want to thank you for supporting local small businesses.
Thrive with Five at the best community bank in the Kanawha Valley, Poca Valley Bank. Poca Valley Bank is now offering a certificate of deposit special, 10-month APY, annual percentage yield 5%. Take advantage of this great rate to grow your savings. For more information, stop by a Poca Valley Bank location today or call 844-782-2651. Poca Valley Bank, where relationships matter. Certain terms and conditions apply. Rates based on minimum annual percentage yield. Subject to change without notice. Minimum deposit required of $10,000 of new money not currently on deposit with Poca Valley Bank to receive APY. Member FDIC.
Hello, I am Judge Stephanie Abraham, and I am running for Circuit Court here in Kanawha County.
Judge Stephanie Abraham was appointed to the Circuit Court by Governor Jim Justice. Judge Stephanie Abraham owned and managed her own law firm and was an attorney for the Department of Education and General Counsel for the State Board of Education. Judge Stephanie Abraham is a fair and balanced but tough judge who will always follow the Constitution to protect liberty and achieve justice for all.
I am Judge Stephanie Abraham. I appreciate your vote for Kanawha County Circuit Court.
Paid for by the committee to elect Judge Stephanie Abraham.
Major phone carriers make you sign contracts with rigid data plans to trap you into a kind of forced phonogamy. Sounds pretty insecure, if you ask me. At Consumer Cellular, we believe in a more consensual and healthy form of phonogamy, free of contracts and more flexible to your data needs. This way, you stick around not because we force you to with contracts and fees, but because you love our phone plans. Like, ardently love our phone plans. Phonogamously. Consumer Cellular. When freedom calls, we're here to answer. Call us at 1-888-FREEDOM.
Keep tabs on the legislators elected to represent you during the 2024 legislative session. Tune in to Hoppy Kercheval and Talk Line, live twice a week from the Rotunda. Our state capitol correspondent, Brad McElhaney, will bring you blow-by-blow coverage straight from the heart of the action. And keep up with our twice-daily capitol reports, breaking news, and daily reactions on the morning news. Comprehensive coverage of the legislative session on your voice of West Virginia and its capital city, 580 WCHS.
It is 9:51 with Dave Allen Show and 580 Live, brought to you by your hometown baseball team, the Charleston Dirty Birds. Maybe wintertime, but we're already thinking baseball at Gilmar Ballpark. 2024 Dirty Birds schedule posted at dirtybirdsbaseball.com. Visit their website for ticket information, promotions, team merchandise, and more. Your hometown baseball team is the Charleston Dirty Birds. Dave, Texas, Dave. CPC shows February above normal, also March and April. So winter, West Virginia winter, may be over along with the above normal the next 2 weeks, says a textualist. Welcome to the show, J.B. McCusker, current state auditor and candidate for attorney general. J.B., how are you, man?
Great, Dave. How are you?
I'm doing fine. You were telling me that during the break I was talking about this swatting story that happened yesterday up in South Hills, and I was, I mean, people, you know, were calling the station and everything about this. It later turned out to be fake, but you're really pretty darn close to the situation. Talk about that.
Yeah, so we had probably, I mean, it's hard to count, but I'd say 25 or 30 first responders go past our house, sirens blaring, you know, going 60, 70 miles an hour on a neighborhood road. And the school, and I was working from home yesterday, and the school is across the street from the house, and that's where my 6 and my 8 year go to school. I have a third grader and a kindergartner at Holt School. And when you see that much police presence speed past your house and your kids are at an elementary school without a security guard, I literally threw on a jacket and my shorts and my slippers and ran up the street in the freezing cold to do whatever I could because I thought they were all going to my kid's school. It was as scared as I've ever been in my life.
I can't imagine that, man.
And the teachers I talked to, I mean, what a disaster swatting is. At some point, we need to probably take a really good hard look at what are the punishments for this? They need to be pretty similar to any other kind of action that puts a first responder in harm's way.
Yeah, like a terroristic type thing. Yeah, you know?
I mean, lock them up and throw away the key,
If they find them, because a lot of times they don't find who it was.
Bury them under the jail. This is a huge problem.
It is.
But at the same time, the bigger problem is that we still haven't, as Senator Tarr and I have been working on for years, figured out a way to prioritize the safety of our school students. There needs to be a resource officer in every single school in West Virginia. No parent should feel the need to sprint to their kid's school at the moment of danger. There should be somebody there protecting our kids. We have found ways to prioritize spending hundreds of millions of dollars on so many things, right? And the safety of our children, I think, should be the most paramount. And I'll continue to fight for this, because I think it is intensely important. I think it is worth every single penny. And I think most importantly, what we know is these things happen everywhere.
Yep.
There is no special bubble around West Virginia that's going to prevent this from happening here, simply because this is a great place to be. It's a very safe place to be. It's a place with great families and great values. But all that being said, the mental health crisis that is affecting teenagers throughout this country is not going to stop at the Virginia, Kentucky, Ohio, and Pennsylvania border.
100% right. Let's get to your campaign. It is official now. JB, you officially signed the paperwork yesterday. You're now a candidate officially for Attorney General. Why do you want to be the AG?
Well, it is, as we were just talking about, being a public servant in West Virginia is a passion. And there is nothing on earth that I work harder for than to allow the people that I live with, the people of the Mountain State, to finally achieve the greatness that this place promises. And we have an incredible opportunity in front of us with economic development, with our location, with our value set. This is the place where young families from around this country are going to want to move, right? And with my long history of being a lawyer, both a constitutional lawyer protecting people's religious liberties, being a private defense attorney working to defend our coal industry and working to defend our gas industry, and then being the auditor and working to reform our entire state government to make it more efficient, more effective, faster, more transparent, and importantly, more accountable to taxpayers. I believe that I have a really unique opportunity to help the next governor both protect our state from rogue Washingtonians and Californians who don't believe that our way of life is appropriate, to defend our values, and to make sure that our government is able to be reformed and turned into a truly taxpayer-centered organization that protects our children, that educates our children, that provides first-class infrastructure, and that gives people who have a little bit less than we do a great opportunity to move up to the middle class. The left has tried for years to paint conservatives as those who don't care about those that are less fortunate, and nothing could be further from the truth. The truth is that conservatives are the ones who truly want to empower the least among us and give them the most opportunity to reach the middle class. And if we do that, the next 25 or 30 years are going to be the most remarkable in our history, and I am excited to fight for every single one of those things and every West Virginian.
What are you most proud of as far as your work as state auditor?
I would say that, you know, the list is so long, Dave. It's like that job interview question when they say, like, you know, what is your biggest fault? It's like, well, yeah, I'm just too humble, right? But, you know, our office has done an incredible job of increasing our own efficiency, increasing our own effectiveness, and increasing our workload while also getting smaller and returning money back to taxpayers. So we have increased our audit load by almost 1,000 audits. We've streamlined the audit process. We've made it significantly faster. We've created demolition programs that have torn down $25 to $30 million worth of dilapidated properties. We've prosecuted more than 45 people to felony fraud conviction throughout the state of West Virginia. And we've created the West Virginia checkbook, made West Virginia the most transparent state in the entire United States, which I think is important. But at the same time, we've done it while decreasing the size of our staff, where staff is down 25%, and decreasing the size of our general revenue budget. So we spend less of your money, we have less people doing it, and we've returned over $100 million to the general revenue in the 7 years that I've been here. And so what I know is that we have committed ourselves to being the lean, accountable, efficient organization that the rest of the government can be. And I'm just super proud of my team and their willingness to buy into my vision in the office. And that's that. It's been the joy of my life to build a team of people that bought in and are so committed to West Virginia taxpayers.
And now how do you transition that? We'll close with this. How do you transition that if you're elected attorney general?
Yeah, the values are the same, right? At the end of the day, the West Virginia taxpayer is the person who needs to be protected. They either need to be protected from a rogue Washington bureaucracy or a rogue Charleston bureaucracy, right? And I have a history of defending our state's values against people who want to stop it. Because here's the deal, Dave. We will not be able to grow if we're not allowed to be ourselves. The reason people want to move to West Virginia is because of who we are, because of our value set, and because of the way that young families can be free to educate their children here. They have a low cost of living. They have a high probability of being close to the things that they want. Outside in nature, everything is beautiful, right? We're close to New York, D.C., you name it. But it's a little alcove of freedom. And we need an attorney general who's going to fight to make sure that our value set is defended. And I'm the person to do that.
And you feel that you are the person to do that?
I know I am.
All right. Where can people learn more about your campaign?
McCuskey4WV.com.
All right. How's the campaign been looking so far? You've been out meeting people and shaking
hands? It's
awesome.
The amount of enthusiasm that we have from the Eastern Panhandle to the Northern Panhandle to the Coalfields, Kanawha, Putnam, Cabell, Harrison, Marion, Mon, Ohio, Berkeley, Jefferson, Mineral, you name it. We have incredible enthusiasm. Fundraising's going incredible. And interest groups and the groups of people in West Virginia are very excited about my vision, and I'm excited to get this race going.
All right. State auditor and now officially a candidate for Attorney General J.B. McCuskey. All right. Appreciate it, man. Thanks a lot. Coming up on the show tomorrow, Don Miller from the Read Aloud West Virginia program will be here. U.S. Senate candidate Glenn Elliott, who's also the mayor of Wheeling, he'll be on the show tomorrow. Prosecuting attorney candidate Morgan Switzer will be on the show tomorrow as well. Got to go. I will see you tomorrow. Till then, have fun and love somebody.
SAM, W243DRFM Charleston, and W283AQ Cross Lanes, a WVRC media station. We're proud to live here too.